It was the perfect vacation. For many, many years, my family had been thinking about visiting Machu Picchu, the greatest ruins in Peru, a place where millions of tourists every year visit. My father, my mother, my brother, and myself came all the way from America to visit Cusco, the capital of the Incas. It was a perfect vacation there. We spent many a week there visiting the best places in Cusco, enjoying the delicious food. Only 10 years later, in 2015, the situation was completely different. My father was losing the ultimate battle against Alzheimer's disease, a disease that was so pernicious that my father changed completely in only 3 to 4 years. How this disease actually changed his life? It is definitely important to know that this disease, to be able to be at least controlled, needs to be detected as early as possible. This disease has no cure as of now. However, the only way for us to control this and to provide some care to the patients and also to the families is to detect it as early as possible, as many people, experts in the field have included. However, that's difficult. It's not easy for professionals, even the most sophisticated, using the most sophisticated technologies, to be able to detect this disease in advance. If you look at a normal brain, it looks definitely complete. If you look at Alzheimer's brain, you will see there the impact of the disease, how the brain deteriorates, eventually leading to a life that is very difficult to manage. It destroys memory, thinking skills, and obviously that takes a huge toll on the patient and the families. However, there is a hope, and the hope comes from artificial intelligence. It will be difficult for humans to look at brain scans, for instance, to detect this disease. However, studies today have demonstrated that artificial intelligence models are able to detect this disease with 90% of accuracy 6 years before diagnostic. That's great time before the disease starts taking its toll. And of course, we can still use some medications today to obtain, to control the disease. That's great help, of course, thinking that patients will be able to go through a CAT scan. That's not always the case. So AI again comes to the rescue. How? There's another study now that actually is able to assess Alzheimer's risk with 70% accuracy by analyzing word usage. If you have interacted with any person being impacted by this disease, you will see indeed that the vocabulary, the language patterns will change completely. And that's something that AI can analyze and use that to provide an advice on how soon the disease is gonna come. That's a great progress also for AI. It's a very easy method to evaluate, to check these patients coming up with a disease, and it doesn't actually need to have an ACAT scan or something very expensive. That's another way that how AI can actually help patients and the people who are actually facing this disease. As of now, there are probably 50 million people going through this disease, and with the aging of the population, we expect these numbers to grow. AI is now helping us to achieve tasks that seemed impossible only a few years ago. If you remember IBM's Watson, for instance, in only a few years ago, this system was able to defeat Jeopardy champions. A very difficult question there. They're giving you an answer, and you're supposed to come up with an intelligent question. People spend years studying for this contest and eventually reach the top echelons of the contest. In this particular case, only a few years ago, Watson was able to defeat champions, human champions who spent years focusing on this. A model was able to ultimately capture the information of this game, eventually studied, being trained for that, and ultimately defeating the champions, and of course, winning $1 million. Jeopardy, it's only one game. Other games too have demonstrated that humans are not anymore the best players. If you think about Go, a traditional Chinese game, for instance, we will remember Google's AlphaGo, how that software, that model made history by defeating the top-ranked human player in the field. This is a very complex game. People even think that it's even much more difficult than chess, which is very traditionally difficult. In that particular case, we saw that Lee Sedol, the champion in the game for many years, was ultimately defeated by this model and apparently was unable to recover personally because we never thought that a computer would be able to reach those heights. However, there was more for AI. AlphaZero was improved by a new software called AlphaGo Zero that even surpassed the heights that the prior software had achieved. AlphaGo Zero was able to surpass all the other versions of the game and become the best player in 40 days, reading and training by self-play, meaning not playing against other humans or other softwares, by learning the game, the rules of the game, and then training itself. You would think that was the end of the story. It wasn't, because AlphaZero, the newest version, was even able to improve that and achieve a level never achieved in terms of professionalism in the game in only 4 hours. So the training was now much, much faster than in only 4 hours. AlphaZero was able to defeat AlphaGo Zero, AlphaGo Lee, the prior versions of this difficult game. Why so difficult for machines to be able to defeat humans? Because the problems that are easy for humans are difficult for computers and vice versa. If you think about payroll, which is something that companies do every 15 days, every month, for instance, it's very easy for a company, for a computer to actually go through that information and then come up with the checks for everybody, for all the employees. However, if we ask the same thing to a human, it will take a long time to be able to compute the real numbers and values of the checks. If you ask a baby to recognize an animal, that's going to be very easy. It will take only one sample, looking at the animal once, for the baby to remember that and never forget that picture. That being said, if you think about a computer, how could you start describing an animal? It will need many, many thousands or even millions of images for this model, for this AI model to be trained. And that's what AI can do. That's a very important task that computers can achieve today when they are trained for many, many, many millions of images. But again, it's only an element of human activity. Obviously, we don't need only recognition of animals. We need a lot of things. And as of now, AI is only focused on narrow applications, image recognition, language processing, and so on. In the future, we will need more. And the path for us is to expand from narrow AI to artificial general intelligence, a level of AI that will actually try to emulate humans in tasks that are going to be more general. Scientists expect once we reach artificial general intelligence, we will get to the next level, artificial superintelligence, when AI will improve itself and eventually become much, much more smarter than humans and even turn against humans. As we will see later, we'll still have a long way to go there. People think that that's going to come in 2060, but personally I believe that it's going to be very pretentious for humans to think that we're able to replicate nature in a very short time frame. If you remember the history of our universe, 13.5 billion years ago, our universe was created. Our galaxy in particular, 4.5 billion years ago, with the initial signs of life. Humans started from the mammals, who became very popular on Earth after the dinosaur disappeared 65 million years ago. So as you can see, those are times that are incredibly long, and that's what it took for us to reach that point of intelligence today. For us humans to replicate that process of nature, it will take longer than that. For now though, AI is already giving fruits. AI is helping students to learn more, to get customized programs so they don't have to rush to learn, but actually learn at their own pace. AI now can help teachers to become more effective. AI is also going to help us in many activities in healthcare. When you think about healthcare, We are trying to look at how we can track our own information. And tracking our own information means that we need to know what's happening in our body, and we will need a lot of sensors to detect that. This information will eventually be sent to our local healthcare provider, to our doctors, to our insurance company, to our own company's employers, and help us to create a better lifestyle decisions for us. That's something that AI can help us as of now. AI is also capable to manage millions of data points. When you think about financial decisions in our lives, we think about, of course, having a child, getting married, buying a car, buying a house, and that's something that we need to think, considering not only our own financial situation, but also economic, macroeconomic points. That's something that is difficult for humans to consider, to take into consideration all these different elements. AI now can help you to take our own information and also this macro information so we can actually arrive to the perfect decision, to the best decision for our own financial independence. A smart cities is another process too. When you think about smart cities, we think of a city where everything will be connected. When we think infrastructure, vehicles, passengers, bridges, all these different elements we see in modern cities are interconnected and are able to communicate. Why is that important? We try to minimize energy in our world. We try to make sure that transportation will become efficient. Nobody would like to spend minutes, hours, trying to find a way to reach to your destination on time. I visited a number of cities traveling, and I've been impressed by how much time you need to spend trying to find a single parking space. Going around, trying to find a space, when actually technology can help us. Already, some cities are doing that. Every parking spot in the city now is with a sensor. So therefore, whenever you are looking to find a parking spot, a computer system will give you the spot and will reserve it for you. So no longer you will need to spend time burning gas and also spending time there. That's one of the beauties of what the concept of smart cities will bring to the table, and AI is a big part of that. Artificial intelligence and insurance too. If you think about insurance, we think about ways to improve the process. If you have the misfortune of having an accident, for instance, you will need to have a human coming to check your car, your house, and so on. That's no longer the case. There are AI models that will allow you to actually create a picture of what happened with your car, with your house, and therefore use that to send information to your insurance company to automatically evaluate the damage and give you an estimate of the claim, how much they're going to pay you for that. That's a great advantage. You no longer have to wait days or hours for that to be solved. That's an application for insurance companies. Similarly, other companies like Didi, Waymo, Baidu, for instance, are using technology AI to create the future of robotaxis. Now we will expect from point A to point B, not to drive or be driven by somebody else, but by a computer. And the computer enables the car to take you safely and on time to your place, thanks to all the progresses that AI has done. It's not easy to do so. Many sensors are going to be embedded in the car to give you that experience. Initially, of course, con the possibility with you managing the car, but eventually driverless options, where you will see a car that no longer will even have a steering wheel or brakes, but just a living room floating around through the roads, taking you from point A to point B. For many years, we saw drones as toys. No, it's no longer the case. Drones can now help you to deliver goods. Companies now can think about moving things from one place to another safely, pinpointing the right location and on time. In today's times, thinking about COVID, contactless delivery, it's a great value added for societies. And drones will definitely help you that, aided by AI. To be able to reach a point from point A to point B, the drone has to be equipped with high resolution cameras that will send images to be processed and therefore identify the best path to get to that destination. So therefore, AI has given us a great point of view for drones that eventually will turn also into other alternatives. When the vehicles were first manufactured more than 100 years ago, we thought that the natural progression would be flying vehicles. We thought it would be easy to achieve that. Guess what? It took a long time. And even now, we're only at the process of testing this type of measurements. So you will see some companies now leveraging the drone technology to actually think about taking humans, and the flying taxis will eventually become part of the image, the sceneries of our major cities. AI is one component of the global trend of technology evolution. From the moment humans invented the wheel all the way to the wonderful advances of AI, technology is never stopping. And another important aspect of technology today comes from two new areas as well: quantum computing and 5G. It's amazing how quantum computing will help AI. When you think about AI, we rely on data, and that data is not easy to manage for today's models. Quantum computing, with computers that will have millions of qubits, will eventually be able to manage this complex model, complex data sets. And furthermore, quantum computing would also help AI to facilitate the training of the complex models that our society will need in the future. 5G. By the end of this year, we expect 190 million of users with smartphones using 5G. What does it mean for all of us? It means that now we will have more data produced and consumed than ever before. And what does AI need? Data. This is a match made in heaven. AI will consume the data 5G is producing, and that will create birth, will give birth to a number of new applications. In the same way that 4G created applications we didn't think before, now 5G will create also a plethora of new applications that people today are thinking in small garages, either in Silicon Valley, in Beijing, or in Tel Aviv. We don't know yet, but you will see that in the next 10, 20 years, these wonderful technologies will change our lives. There are some challenges, yes. If you think about the introduction of vehicles, we thought people will lose jobs. Many people who were working in these industries will eventually lose jobs, and that's indeed what happened. So some people at some moment might have said, we don't need to have automobiles. People will still moving around with transitional transportation methods. We were concerned that automobiles might kill people, unfortunately. So therefore, some people might have said, no automobiles today. Guess what? Humankind has improved. I think we all have to thank automobiles for our well-being, for the well-being of our societies. And I think that's the general role of technology. So today, we hear a lot of people saying AI will definitely take over some jobs that were traditionally done by humans. So maybe we should limit somehow the prevalence of AI. Let me tell you something. AI is just the application of technology. At the end of the day, somebody has to create AI. Somebody has to maintain AI. And definitely AI will also enable a plethora of new jobs and opportunities. If you think about the internet, nobody thought about it, let's say 30 years ago, how prevalent it became. Guess what? The internet not only became prevalent, but now some people actually make a living out of the internet. Opportunities that nobody thought before the advent of the internet. That is the technology, the story of technology. And that's something we will see with AI, bringing challenges, but also humankind will rise up and respond to that challenge by getting trained, getting better prepared, and creating new applications of these wonderful technologies. The AI revolution is about to start, and we will be part of this wonderful future for mankind. Thank you very much.